I'm going to tell you a story that really happened. It happened to a good friend of mine, Arnold, and his dog, Professor. One beautiful morning early in the summer, Arnold, as was his custom, took his dog, Professor, out for a run. They lived in the glorious inland city of Wagga Wagga in the Riverina, Australia. One of their favourite places to go for a run was at the Wagga Beach. It wasn't really a beach, but that's what everybody called it because it was a nice sandy bit of shoreline along the bank of the Murrumbidgee River where you could have a picnic, go for a swim, catch the 5 o'clock wave, or be generally silly in the sand. They set off, out the front gate, towards the river. At the beach. There were very few people, as it was still very early, but it was alive with the sounds of nature. This particular morning, Arnold and the Professor ran along the Murrumbidgee towards the north. They ran past Wilkes Park and North Wagga to the Murrumbidgee wetland, far, far, far away. They loved to listen to the sounds of the river, the wind in the gum trees, and all the amazing birds. Thank you. They stopped to rest for a while. Arnold took Professor off the leash, so he could poke around and sniff at all the fun things in the grass. As they sat and sniffed about, they watched a duck swimming on the far side of the river. Suddenly, Professor ran into the water and started swimming after the duck. Arnold called after him to return. But unfortunately, Arnold had never been very good at training things other than his guitar, and Professor ignored him and continued to swim and swim and swim after that duck. Oh, he was clearly having a wonderful time in the cool water, and so too, it seems, was the duck. Very soon became obvious the professor was not returning, and the duck was clearly winning. Professor was getting further and further away, and Arnold, in a moment of desperation, heroically decided to go after him. He stripped off his clothes, well, nearly all of them. He jumped into the river and swam after him. Professor was managing to swim upstream, but Arnold, who had overestimated his aquatic skill, was swept downstream with the rather strong current. Some weeks later, at a small gathering involving pizza, Arnold conceded that this was really a very, very silly thing to have done. Eventually, Professor gave up on the duck, and he and Arnold found themselves on the other side of the river, a very long way from where they had started. Luckily, they had arrived on the bank at the back of a farm, near the farmhouse. Thank you. The couple who lived in the farmhouse had seen them climbing up the bank and came out to investigate. They were very curious to know what sort of person would be mucking around in the water in his underpants in the middle of nowhere so early in the morning. Well, they were very friendly. Well, of course. And they listened with genuine interest as Arnold told them about the incident with the duck. No smirk at all, lent Arnold some clothes and drove him and Professor home. Arnold, who was a particularly fine example of a human, wanted to show his gratitude for the couple's kindness. He had noticed that lined up along the back veranda of the farmhouse, there was a not insignificant number of empty beer bottles. Arnold had taken a mental note of the brand, which was clearly their favourite. He purchased a case of this beer and delivered it to the farmhouse when he returned the man's clothes. The farming couple recognized Arnold immediately on his arrival and, as is typical of the well-developed Australian sense of irony, commented that they almost didn't recognize him now that he had his clothes on. They were very pleased to see him, and also the case of beer. As they said goodbye, they smiled happily with barely a hint of a smirk. Arnold smiled very cheerily as he drove away, knowing that the world was just a tiny bit better today than it was yesterday.